Hi class, welcome to another example. This one says, let's say we were listening to KLAQ 95.5 radio station and a random student asked what was the wavelength of KLAQ's radio signal. Before we jump in and work on the problem, we need to do a little review on prefixes, and I'll use frequency to illustrate that example. So, the unit for frequency is the hertz, as we know. Now, if you had 1,000 hertz, you could say, I have 1,000 hertz, or you could express this as 1 kilohertz. These two are the same. Now, this is a prefix, kilo. Just like kilogram is 1,000 grams, kilo is the prefix for 1,000. Now, if we were using scientific notation, we would express this as a number followed by times 10 to the third power. Now, what if you had 100,000 hertz? The prefix for 100,000 is mega, and the mathematical expression when you're using scientific notation would be times 10 to the sixth power. Not that we know the prefix mega and kilo, we're going to use mega. The reason being is each radio station has a specific frequency and it happens to be this number. For KLAQ 95.5, this is their frequency in megahertz. So let's use the space. Let me draw a line. So we can start working on KLAQ. KLAQ. And the problem, actually, in KLAQ. So frequency is 95.5. megahertz, capital M, 8Z, which is the same as 95.5 times 10 to the 6th hertz. And we're looking for the wavelength or lambda? Question mark. Now you could say we're also missing the velocity. Although it is not here in the problem explicitly, it is implicitly. Radio waves are a form of electromagnetic waves. And if you remember from the first lesson, light is an electromagnetic wave. So all EMW, which is electromagnetic waves, travel at the same speed, which is the speed of light. So in physics, it is usually expressed as C. Speed of light. But we can write it just so it's not confusing as VEMW, which is electromagnetic wave, equals C. And this is a constant of nature, which is 3.0 times 10 to the 8th power meters per second. So this is the velocity or the speed of radio waves. Now we do have that variable, so let's write it. VEMW equals 3.0 times 10 to the 8 meters per second. Don't forget the units. We have frequency, velocity, we need wavelength. Now let's work on using the triangle from the lesson. So we have our hand because we're going to cover up a variable with a glove, because you know we're going through a pandemic, coronavirus. So we cover up the one we're looking for, which is lambda, wavelength. There you go. And notice how we have V and frequency, or velocity, frequency. Top, bottom. This is going to mean we're going to divide velocity by frequency. Lambda, wavelength, equals velocity divided by frequency because of the triangle. So let's write an equation. Lambda equals velocity divided by frequency. Lambda equals 3.0 times 10 to the 8th meters per second divided by 95.5 times 10 to the 6th hertz. Whenever we're using exponents, scientific notation, it is very important that we use parentheses. Remember, parentheses are your friends. So let's go 3. Instead of using times 10, I'm going to use double E function. Very important, very useful. E to the 8th, close parentheses, divided by 95.5. Double E times 10 to the 6th power. I missed the parentheses over here, so let me add it. There you go. 3 times 10 to the 8th divided by 95.5 times 10 to the 6th, which is this equation over here. We press enter, and we have 3.14136. I know what you're thinking. Yes, this is the first three digits of pi. And I thought that was pretty cool. But maybe you don't think so because you don't like physics as much as I do. But maybe you do. I don't know. So we'll write, we're going to use, let's go for red ink. So, lambda equals 3.14 meters. That is the answer. Fun story. When I was in college, we did a problem like this using KLAQ, and my professor, Dr. Vanuelos, he was so... What is the word I'm looking for? He was so happy that pi was the wavelength of KLAQ because he also likes KLAQ. So I thought it was pretty cool. That's it, guys. Bye.